Hi everyone, welcome to this Twinmotion tips and tricks video. Today we'll be looking at some behind the scenes of this Night City project that we created for the Twinmotion community challenge. And actually today we'll be going in depth into the lighting of this Night City scene. So the first step I'm going to do is come to the media doc image, and here I have set up one image that is the final image that we use for the challenge. And here I have the same point of view but without any rain, without any lighting effect. So I'm going to switch to that, I'm going to duplicate that, I will click on the mirror and just switch to a wider format of image so we have a better preview and we can better see what's going on inside our screen. And same thing, I'm just switching the fove so we can have a better look at our project. So the first thing I need to do obviously is switch to the night. So I will come to the location and just change the time of day until it's middle of the night. Then the second most important thing obviously is to add some rain. So here I'm just going to drag the weather slider to have the rain like that. One other thing also, I don't want to have this really long distance field here. What I want to do is add some fog to make it like the rain particle is floating all around in the air. So we'll come to the effect and I will here raise the smog around 80%. Start to look great, but now let's actually start to add some light. My camera will be placed roughly over here, so one of the first thing I added is some light in front of our camera just to enlight the foreground of our image. Let me come back over here. I've selected this light on my scene graph and I'm just going to turn them on. I'm not going to recreate all the lighting from scratch, I'm just going to turn this light on one at a time. Then after that, one of the lights I've added is all the light that we can see here, the window in front of our project. So I'm just going to select all of them and turn them all on. As you can see, it catches a bit the haze, the fog, and it adds a bit of mist around the window, and I think it looks cool. Next, what I did is add some lights on top of the hotel sign over here. Same thing here, it catch a bit the particle, the rain particle all around the project. And also added this one on top of our building because it's supposed to have some glass roof on top of it. Then here I thought like we are missing some colors, so I went in my camera here into the visual effect, color gradient, and I'm just, instead of the basic color gradient, I just switched to, I think it was, yeah, Beauty 2. Like the colors feel a bit more vibrant, yeah, feel just, it was more in the look of what I'm aimed for this project. Then what was next? As you can see here on the back we have this building. I did the same thing as for the window over here. I added some area light just to catch a bit the haze, the fog over here. I did the same thing here. I've placed randomly some omnidirectional light again just to catch a bit more the haze, faking a bit that some of these lights produce light on all the rain particle all around. Same thing over here on the right. I've also added, to add more contrast around our building, I started adding some light behind it on this building over here, but also on our hotel. So if I just select some of this light over here, just going to turn all of those guys on. Here we have a couple of street lights. In the final shot, we don't even see these, but yeah, I've just started adding some lights. Same thing over here on the right. I've added some lights on the surrounding building to mimic the fact that we have some city lighting in place all around. Next step here was to start adding some light inside of our hotel to add some life to the context, to the surrounding. Then what's next? We add some props in front of our camera. So here we have in the street props, we have we have that. So we have our bench over here with a display on the side. Near this display, I just added a basic area light, really small one, to the trick. And I've specifically changed the color. By default, it's white, but I just changed the color to match a bit the color I have inside my image over here. And I did the same thing for my holographic display that I have here using an area light with the same color as my image. And finally, for the street here in front of our camera, I've used a basic material, tiles. And what I wanted to actually, I've used basic material with some reflection. I've raised a bit the reflection to make this material a bit wet. And finally, what I did to make this material even more wet is basically adding some puddle decal from the library. So here, if you open the object, decals, and if you scroll here, we have two different puddles. So here you can just play, add some puddles, it catch the rain, you can change the opacity, you can change the scale to make your puddles bigger or smaller. So here it can just really be a small puddle between two different tiles. So again, it's some little subtle effect, but if you look closely at our road over here, it definitely had some realism to the road. It had some more randomness in front of our building over here. And I didn't do that all over the place. It was really based on my camera position. So my camera was there. So I added really a couple of ones just in front of our project. So we'll see also the project in the reflection in these puddles. And finally, to finish, I just added the car with the light streak. And same thing here, the light that we have on the back of the car catch a bit the haze, the fog. So yeah, I think that's it for the lighting of this scene. That was the final look. As you can see here, you have the pedals, you have the light of the car, you have this big light over here, like, I think those two lights are really the most important one in our overall image. It makes the top of the image really interesting. We have the puddles in the middle of in the bottom of the image that also add a lot of interesting things to see. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it for this one. Hope you find this video helpful, and I will see you guys for the next one. Bye everyone.